I like told them, oh, you guys are guesting on the show.
Wait, you saw them in the airport?
Saw them in the airport.
Do you know that she gets our guests from the airport? Yeah.
That's why.
Yeah, that's why. No, no, I was going to guess the other congressman, but since I saw them and they were there, I asked them and they said yes. So I'm like, okay, cool. I go, I'm not going to reconfirm. Okay, that's set. And they're like, okay.
Okay, so who are the other siblings in Congress? Like you have...
We only have one uncle that's in Congress right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then in the whole, what other families? Like the two of yours?
No, we have Dato and Mikey.
Yes, Arroyo.
Then, I think they're four.
Then four yeah, they're four brothers and sisters? Who?
No.
Sorry, the uncle...
Oh, yeah, the uncle.
Right.
Okay, mm-hmm. And then the two of you, and who else?
Oh, us? We have one... Oh, in Congress?
Yes, in Congress.
There's only three of us in Congress.
Okay, and then other families. So other the Arroyos, the Jalosjos, and...
There's a lot.
They're husband and wife teams.
Oh. There's mother and daughter.
There's mother and daughter.
Aliyah and Dimaporos.
Aliyah and Imelda Dimapora.
Okay.
And then there's husband and wife that's... Bardoni and
a husband and wife.
Yeah, husband and wife, and then their brothers, and it's just an interesting mix because the 15th Congress there are like 114 new legislators. Yeah. We've got everything: like mother, daughter, half. You know, husband and wife, two set of brothers. We've got Pacquiao, we've got Imelda, we've got GMA,
yes. Mm-hmm.
We've got GDV, Lucy, Lanny,
QT.
Yeah.
It's just we have 23 ex mayors, we have 30 something ex governors. So and we have like secretaries from like Artyap and
Yeah,
Biazon.
Okay, what are the rules in Congress? Like, you know, all of you are from there, and my father was from there. But you know, like with regard to clothing for men,
John wouldn't be able to go in wearing this.
No.
Because
it's short sleeve.
Short sleeve barong's not allowed.
So that's long sleeves. You just fold.
Yeah,
you just
this is okay.
And you can wear. You can go in there folded.
I can, but I don't. I usually don't.
Yeah, you shouldn't. It's got to be long sleeve.
It has to be formal.
Yeah. It's got to be long sleeve.
Okay, well, guys don't really wear three-fourths. Yeah. Like, you don't think of shirts like
In
that.
In the past Congress, they were not so strict. Like, there was one lady who used to go there. I can say braless, right?
Okay,
yeah, so anyway, I'm not going to say her name. But she used to do that. And when I used to observe them, they used to wear, like, really short skirts. Mm-hmm. But now it seems like they're really getting strict. Like, they actually made someone not... attend okay. session because he wasn't wearing the proper...
What was he wearing?
He was wearing short sleeve barong.
Same. I see.
It's guayabera also.
So you Sorry? Have...
Guayabera also. So a different
yes.
color.
Yeah. Okay, so you have to wear a barong and it has to be long sleeve.
No,
so
it's got
to
be long sleeve barong.
So you can wear a shirt, a long sleeve shirt?
No.
So it has to be a long sleeve barong.
Long sleeve barong.
Coat?
Or a coat.
Or a coat.
Yeah. Okay. And for the females, the counterpart of that.
Which is?
Filipiniana, which they want us to wear every Monday, more or less.
Or a suit.
Or a suit.
Okay,
a
so suit. If you go in that, you'll have to wear
a... I have a jacket.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, I see. And when did they tell? I mean, during the
From day
the
one,
opening,
it's there in the rules.
No, but
it's
in the opening, there. People were wearing... they weren't wearing coats.
The guys?
Wearing jackets. No, the girls.
The girls. Well, in the opening, usually they're all in Filipiniana.
Oh, yeah. I see. That's interesting. What about shoes? Can you wear open
They're
shoes
not,
for girls?
No, definitely not. Definitely not. But some of them like try to wear the shoes that doesn't even have a sling in the back, which
yes.
You know, they're wearing a suit and then they're wearing those shoes. It doesn't really go.
They're closed, but they're open in the back.
Yeah, I find that Mules. They should be stricter with shoes because a lot of girls, you know.
And the boys, you can wear anything. I mean, of course, clothes.
Yeah, anything.
Leather. Mm-hmm. With socks.
yeah,
with a tattoo. We'll find out about the tattoo when we come back. Meantime, we're just going to have to take a look at it.
We're still on She Said, She Said with the Jalosjos brothers of the lower house. We have some presents for you from Classic Herbs Corporation. Antimicrobial soap and hot chocolate. Okay, now let's talk about your tattoo. It is not a birthmark. I mean, okay. I've never seen a birthmark that looked
like
that.
It's huge.
It's not that big. So I had it when I was 18. And, you know, I don't think that you should have a certain image if you're a legislator or whatever.
Well, that's why you have socks on.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
But
there you
go. Saw it. Maybe
so
your socks should be a little longer.
Yeah,
right?
I know,
knee socks.
Knee socks.
So can I see it?
Over the knee socks.
They saw it not even.
Yeah, I want to see it.
I'll show it later.
Okay.
No, you know, we have footage on it anyway. I want to ask you what.
Why?
See, he's laughing.
Why did you have
John
done?
Laughs a lot.
Well, yeah.
Was it because
I like
came into your mind?
No, I was in the U.S. and I like going to the beach. Mm-hmm. And
so this
was
in Hawaii?
No, this was in L.A. And I had them put a Polynesian
girl.
It's a goddess of water.
Goddess of water.
Yeah, so it's a symbol of water. I like the beach. And
you like the beach?
Yeah,
and
like
you dive?
Beach. And I dive, so.
What other water sports do you do?
A lot. I do wakeboarding, anything in water.
Mm-hmm. So you're basically a real athletic.
Yeah, yeah. I like outdoor stuff.
Mm-hmm. And do you enjoy all the sports as well, especially the water sports?
Yes.
So do you guys do it together? Do you live far from each other? Do you have to take a plane or can you?
No.
It's like
you can drive. It's like
drive.
How long?
3 hour drive.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Is there
drive.
Any way you can take a plane? But you guys took a plane together. So at what point from the airport, how far till you get to
from
the
Dipolog Airport to my district, it's 10 minutes.
And to your district?
3 hours.
Oh, wow.
So we.
And you go home every weekend?
Yes.
Where's the family? Are they in Dipolog as well?
Yes. No. They're at my province.
Oh, okay.
In your province. Okay, and then when you come back to Manila, you have to leave so many hours before you because you're so close to the airport.
That's right.
No, I sleep at Dapitan, Takak, Sunday.
Okay,
before
on Sunday. And so you guys fly back every Monday morning?
Yeah.
We'll see and then you go back every
Thursday. Or Friday.
It just depends.
Okay. Are there times that you stay here in Manila also? Or you really have to go back every week?
We try to go back. If there's another, we can extend another day. But I think it's just right that since we just, it's our first term.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't want to take it for granted. We don't want to see the people na hanap-hanapin ka, na you're not in your district.
Yeah, okay. So I want to know, like for all three of you, you go home and then you actually open your office every Friday?
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Our office
is Friday,
open every
Saturday,
day.
And Sunday?
Yes.
Sunday our office is open.
Especially Sunday.
So, you have no day off.
No, so we actually work.
We work every day of the week.
Every single day.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
That's
well,
what I say.
Thursdays,
I work every day.
You have sessions Monday to Wednesday.
Monday to Wednesday.
And then Thursdays, you're traveling.
Not really. Like tomorrow, we have, it's our budget hearing, so we're going to be attending that.
Tomorrow is Sunday.
No.
You?
So on Thursdays
you...
Even, it's supposed to be still a session day. Mm-hmm. So meetings can be held on Thursdays. So that's why you kind of can't go home yet every Thursday unless you want to go home like Thursday afternoon because there's always still some meetings that may happen.
So your office is open even on Sundays. Okay, well, that's also good, of course, for your people.
What are your committees?
I'm vice chair of foreign affairs, aquatic resources.
Did you ask for that?
No, they just gave it. I was,
perfect.
Yeah, it's perfect.
And also aquatic, so you have two vice.
Two vice.
And then
membership. Membership, health, labor, APRO, and what else? I think that's it.
John.
Yeah.
Vice.
Labor.
Mm-hmm.
And Mindanao Affairs.
Mm-hmm. And memberships.
APRO, both education, lower and higher. Transportation.
Why education? You both have. Did you ask for education, both of you?
Mm-hmm. I did.
So you can actually ask for.
You can
to
request,
be a member of a committee.
You list down their priorities in specific order, and they'll try to accommodate you. If they can't, then they will go to the next one in line. Mm-hmm. So
who's the one who chooses?
Basically,
the speaker. I think the speaker.
June Abaya.
He does
chair.
Everything.
No, the party.
Well, Speaker, June Abaya, and you know, a couple
different
of people.
Parties, the different
yeah.
parties.
And then can you
and then,
given
wait,
slots.
The minority have certain slots, the majority have certain slots.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, for example, if you're this much, maybe 10 from majority and, like, maybe 2 from minority. So, the minority leader, like Lagman, puts in people also. Mm-hmm. So it really depends.
So yeah. can we trade places?
No.
No, I don't think so.
Like, let's say I like your committee and you like mine, and I'd rather be there. And you can't do that?
You can't do that.
It's our first term.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. You can't really. And you can't really be chair of any committee in your first term. And they're very strict about that.
Yeah.
They're very strict about everything this year.
Why? Did you want to be the chairman of a committee already?
Of course. Why not?
Oh.
Why not? And not even that. Like, certain committees, you can't even have membership there if it's your first term. But they were not that strict in the past Congresses. But now they're very strict in, you know, implementing everything in the rules.
Yeah, but you're all first termers.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay, so you are, is there a limit to your membership?
No.
No, but it's just, if you can handle it. Because like him, he has a lot of committees, so he has to go every single day, different times.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes four committees in same
a day.
Yeah, sometimes you're running from one room to the other.
Yes.
So that's why they say it's not really practical for you to have more than five committees, because you're practically there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and mm-hmm. the committees are in the morning or in the afternoon, so there's just no time for you to be going to everything and attending everything, mm-hmm. especially if you're vice chair and like both happening at the same time. So you can, used to be in the past, they're members of like 10 committees and all, but they don't really attend anymore. So this time, 15th Congress, they tried to implement the, mm-hmm. tried to stick to five more or less. So okay, we all have five, right?
So let's say you attend one committee and then you ask somebody else to attend another meeting, another
You
hearing?
Can have you your can, chief of staff attend.
Okay, what about, let's say you have five. You ask somebody to attend, a representative, and all five?
No, there are probably like two going on at the same time.
Yeah.
Right. More or less.
Okay, but if you have your chief of staff attend, can he or she speak in your behalf?
No, they're not allowed to vote. Okay. Or
When my father was senator, I used to attend meetings for him because he would attend one and I would attend the other. And there were other people who attended for their senators, and they used to speak and speak and speak because before it was allowed. And then they made a ruling: if you're a representative or if you're not the senator, you cannot speak.
That's right.
I think that's better.
Yeah, I think it's also better.
Yeah.
Because they really rule the house.
And besides, as it is, they already speak too long. They take too long. I mean, to get one point across, it's like 5 minutes. So, and plus, there are all these people who love to speak.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Having someone else, like a chief of staff, speak on your behalf mm-hmm. is not really going to be welcome.
Yes. Yeah. So, what bills have you passed, or what bills are you planning to pass?
I'm actually. I filed a bill trying to change or see if we can adopt another name for our province. Because I used to be a chairmanship for tourism in my province as board member. And it was so hard for us to sell the province as it is.
Because
it had that stigma of terrorism, bombings in Zamboanga, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? So kidnappings and all that.
So what name do you want to change it to?
We actually adopted a name called Zanorte. It's like Kamsur.
Yeah. Okay.
So it's shorter, but it omits the Zamboanga mm-hmm. part, right? And actually, it was an ordinance that I passed also when I was board member. I just want to continue that and bring it to the national mm-hmm. level and see if we can pass it as a bill.
Okay. And John?
Me.
Yes.
One thing is I want to clarify and clear the path of the indigenous people representation in the local government unit mm-hmm. because we're part Sobanen. It's a minority group. Our family is part of the Sobanen tribe. Mm-hmm. So as of the moment, there is existing law that appoints in all local government agencies one representative from the minority, the indigenous people.
Last question. Where'd you guys study?
La Salle.
Here?
Yeah.
You also, John?
I am in Erling.
Oh, okay. So you all studied here, Manila?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Wait, I wanted to know how long is it until a bill is passed and approved?
Oh, it depends. It depends. Yeah. Sometimes you can go through first reading, second reading, third reading, and it's not approved in Senate, so it just goes back and you have to refile it the next Congress.
Sometimes your term is over and...
Yeah. And yeah.
Most of the time.
What is the shortest time? That a bill
it really
was
depends.
It depends. It depends. Like the shortest one could or would have been something like resetting the barangay elections, because everyone's focused on that. They need to act on it before the elections come up.
But it's a national issue, so I think that's it takes
something
longer.
Like that.
But if it's a local, you know, local bill, mm-hmm. it's not that hard. I think. I think in your term, once your term's done, you can pass local bills.
Yeah.
1 term.
Okay, but so I'd like to thank you guys for joining us here tonight.
Thank you. Thank you for your time. I know you have a meeting to attend to. It's late already.
Yeah. And thank you for being here.
Thank you. I know you guys are really busy.
Thank you, John and Bullet, for your time.
Thank you.
So we'll see you guys soon. But don't go away yet. We'll be right back. We'd like to thank you for joining us tonight. We hope you watch us every single Saturday night right here on NBN4. But we'd like to thank a few of our friends who are always there for us. Tony and Guy, I'd like to thank Tere and TJ and Gian.
And I'd like to thank Aga and Tina and Gian also.
I'd like to thank Christy for my haircut. And we'd also like to thank SM.
Yes, thank you to SM Department Stores. Thank you to AC.
Yes, thanks AC. They've got it all for us.
Yes, and we'd like to thank 360 Degrees Fitness Club. Thank you also to Mabolo Flower Shop. And thank you also to Concha and Associates for our set. Thank you.
I'd like to thank Ferrymar for my accessories. Thanks Iris and her daughter Mia. And the girls there, Detma, Helen, Arlene, and Chloe. Thank you to Metro for my clothes. And thank you to Beverly Hills 6750.
I would like to thank Shimian Manila. And thank you also to Classic Herbs Corporation. Thank you.
Wow, that was so interesting.
I know. They were so much fun.
I know, right?
You could really see the difference. I mean, physically and even in their personality.
I know. One was single, one was married.
Yes.
One was shy
and the other one was shyer. No, he wasn't shy at all.
Yeah, but they like to rag on each other, which is kind of cool.
I know, and I found it cute that they were like teasing each other and laughing at each other.
And that's such a great example of how family should be. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter, even if you're half brothers, you see how close they are.
Yes, I know.
The bond that they have.
And they live together until now.
And they share an apartment and they really get along.
I know. It's cool. It's like friends.
I know. But we're going to have another interesting guest next week.
Yes.
So make sure you guys catch us.
See you all. Have a nice weekend. Goodbye.
Good night.
Yes, we'd like to recognize the speaker. Speaker?
It's only 2-3% because 515,000. And what we're waiting for is 12,000 votes.